What an entry. Bob Sapp, 141 kilos, and he's got the gown of a king around his shoulders.
I think he's taking a page out of Ric Flair's book.
Let's just watch.
Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a BJJ champion, standing at 195 centimeters and weighing in at 115 kilograms, with a professional MMA record of 5 wins and 1 loss. From Brazil and fighting out of the legendary Renzo Gracie Academy, Rolles Gracie! His opponent in the red corner. This man stands at a beastly 196 centimeters and weighs in at 159 kilograms with a professional record of 11 wins and 9 losses. From the United States of America, fighting out of Team Beast, K1 and Pride veteran,
come together, and already it's brutal, but Sapp is down on his back, and this is one of the conceivable ways that it could end, because Gracie is an excellent submission fighter. This fight is brought to you by Jaco, and it may not be a long one, Jason.
You know, Hollis did exactly what Hollis needed to do. Get the fight to the ground as quickly and efficiently as possible. I'm actually kind of surprised that Bob Sapp was able to work a little bit of guard and survive an ankle lock attempt. So this could be a little longer fight than we anticipate.
Well, he's tried his hand at a number of different fighting styles, Bob Sapp. This is his latest modus operandi. Used to be an American footballer with the Minnesota Vikings.
Bob Sapp has done everything. He's a movie star, he's a product endorser, you know, former K1 kickboxer and MMA fighter. Bob takes a lot of flack. People think that, you know, he's not really an MMA fighter, and he wants to prove that this is Bob Sapp 2.0.
Oh, there's a big punch that Gracie just landed. He tried for a second. The first one really got through, and the last couple have as well. And Bob Sapp could be in trouble, and it is over. They were heavy punches. I could see them very clearly here. Bob Sapp was on his back, and he took 2 or 3 heavy, heavy blows from Rolles Gracie. Bob Sapp's up, that's the way it is in MMA. Great sportsmanship from Bob Sapp, but he took some big, big blows to the head. And make no mistake, Rolles Gracie is a huge man in his own right. And he's got great athleticism. He really let Bob Sapp have it there on the ground. And you know, when the blows are coming in as heavy as those were, they cannot last for long. You can't let a fight like that go on for much longer, because it's serious stuff. It's dangerous stuff. And great respect to our referee for jumping in time. Let's take another look. It went to the mat quickly, as we expected it would. But then our expectations were that Gracie would get a submission. But it's these blows that you're seeing with the right hand that did the damage. And you could see the pain on Bob's face there. He took one at the top of the head, on the back of the head, which is often dangerous and can dull your senses. We said it would be quick, folks. And it certainly was. Some speculation as to whether Bob Sapp actually tapped out there and called the fight before the referee got a chance. Let's hear the official word in a few moments.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by way of tap out due to strikes. After 1 minute, 18 seconds of round one, from the